from buying diapers to buying double of everything that you have to baby is hard enough as it is. And then when you talk about to pack of diapers these days is 5,200, guys. 5,200.
Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Or if you're stopping by for the first time, you're welcome. So in this video, I'm going to be sharing my struggles as a first-time mom of twins. I always wanted twins. I've always prayed to have twins, but I didn't think about these factors. I didn't know that it was going to be such a big deal.
Pregnant.
I was preparing my mind and my body for a vaginal birth. The first thing that hit me about having twins was the C-section that I had to have. I know that there are exceptions where people have twins vaginally, but my own case wasn't so. I had a C-section and I didn't see that one coming. Like, it was a huge deal to me. Not even because of the sentiments surrounding C-sections, especially in this part of the world, not because of that.
It
It was
was all.
because of the fact that I expected that I would just give birth and I'll spring right back into recovery. I didn't expect to be nursing a wound or an incision. I didn't think about all that. Like I said, I was preparing my mind and my body for a vagina. But I ended up having a C-section, and after that, the next thing which surprised me, which I didn't see coming, and I definitely did not anticipate, was my long stay in the hospital. So when you have twins, especially if they are born before the 40 weeks mark, which is almost always the case, the doctors want to make sure that your twins are fine. If they're born prematurely, they're sent to the NICU, and then you have to stay in the hospital for long. You may not have to stay if they're going to stay for so long. Maybe you have to go and come back. But my twins were born at 37 weeks, which is not considered premature or preterm, although they were not full term either. They didn't get to the 40 weeks mark, so they were not full term, but 37 is good enough. So we're in the hospital for I was in the hospital from Sunday to Saturday, or to Friday actually. Like, people who came before me, with me, on the same day as me, the days after me, they all left. Like, the only person that I left in the world when I was leaving came the day before I left. So it was really something I didn't want. If you've had a baby before, you know that there is no feeling such as wanting to get back home. Like, you just want to get back home and take your baby home and take care of your baby at home. So enduring those long nights, the long stay in the hospital, was something I definitely did not see coming, and it wasn't a pleasant day. It wasn't pleasant. Of course, it cannot be pleasant sleeping in the hospital. So there's that. And then once we got back home, another thing that hit me was sleep deprivation. So this one, I am still battling with this. Like, up till now, my twins don't go a whole night without waking up. Sometimes they wake up twice. Like, each person wakes up twice because I'm still breastfeeding actively. So it has gotten better, thank God. It definitely has. But in the first 2 months, I thought I was losing my mind. Like, I was just surviving. I was in full-blown survival mode, just taking each day as it came and not worrying about the next day, wondering if I'll make it to the next day. Like, it was a lot to deal with. It was. And if you've been following my channel, then you know that I'm in a long distance relationship, so like a long distance marriage. So it was just me. My mom was here. My mom stayed for a long time actually, but there's only so much that she could do. There was only so much that she could do. So it was me and them. And then I got to realize that sleep is highly overrated. That is one thing that I have come to realize in this journey. I know that sleep is important. Before I had my babies, sleep, I was a sleep person. Like, I was the kind of person who didn't sleep less than 7 to 8 hours in a day. I took my sleep very seriously, from napping during the days whenever I had the time to sleeping long hours at night, like 7, 8 hours at night. I would not even like to get up to pee. If I did get up to pee, I'll be annoyed myself. So that's how much I valued my sleep. But since after the first 2 months of my twins' life, I've come to realize that I can do well with minimal sleep. Like before, if I slept anything short of 5, 6 hours in a night, I would wake up with a banging headache. But now, it's not so anymore. I think my body has just adjusted, because from the first 2 months, it was having 2 hours of sleep or even less, because they'll go to sleep around 11 and wake up maybe an hour later and then start to cry and cry and cry until 5 a.m. before they'll go back to sleep and wake up at 7 again. I know that people say you sleep when your babies sleep or when your babies sleep during the day. It's not so easy. I think it's easier said than done, because while they are sleeping in the day, you are trying to get other things done, especially if you don't have help. So I didn't grow up in this part where I'm staying right now. So my family is not here, my friends are not here, I don't have adequate hands and help. And I'm the kind of person who just likes to do stuff by herself. And having twins did not change that. I just felt that I could do my own things better by myself. So that didn't quite work for me, yeah. It didn't quite work for me, because during the day when they'll be sleeping and they hardly even slept for long, my babies battled colic for a long time in the first couple of months. So it wasn't easy. They didn't quite sleep long periods, so it wasn't easy for me to say I would finish what I had to do when they slept, maybe have my bath, have a meal, and then go right back. I mean, go back to sleep, join them to sleep. Before I knew what was happening, they'll be awake already. Like, I hardly even spent time in the shower. Whenever I went into the shower, it was like they knew I was out of their sight and in the shower. That was when they would start to cry, and then I'll have to rush through my shower and come out. Sometimes I won't even bother moisturizing because I have to breastfeed. Another thing that I didn't see coming that I'm definitely struggling with, we're definitely struggling with up till now, is our finances. So nobody prepares you for this, you know, when you're going to have a baby, especially in these parts of the world. People say God that gave you the baby will take care of you, or provide for the baby, or provide for you to provide for the baby. I remember before I got married, and I was telling my mom one time, and I said to her, I wanted to wait 1 year post marriage, post wedding, to start having kids or trying for kids. And one of my reasons was I wanted us to gain financial stability before going into that, before bringing children. And then she said to me, like the typical Nigerian parent, God that provides the children will provide the finances to take care of them. I don't doubt God. I definitely believe in God, but I still believe that you should have a plan. You should have a plan. You should definitely know what you are doing before you get into it. But having twins has made me realize that you can never be prepared, like really prepared for these things. You think you have it covered, and then when it happens, when they come, oh God, baby, wait. When they come, it's like, no, what were you doing? What were you doing all this while? So from buying diapers to buying double of everything that you have to buy, it's definitely not easy. Taking care of even one baby, like just one baby, is hard enough as it is. And then when you talk about two, a pack of diapers these days is 5,200, guys. 5,200. I will go through two packs in a month. Imagine how much money you were spending just on diapers. Not to talk about the thing I'm struggling with is the loneliness that comes with being a twin mom. So, because there are two babies, it is such a chore to take them out, to go out in public, especially if you don't have a babysitter, a nanny like me. It is like this baby, you want this baby to sleep before you take the other baby out if you have to go out, because they hardly ever sleep at the same time. My twins, they don't sleep at the same time. It is one person sleeps and the other person wakes up when that one is trying to sleep. And as that one is waking up, this other one goes to sleep. So they cannot both, they hardly ever both sleep at the same time, giving you time to do what you want to do or go wherever you want to go and come back. That is almost impossible. And it gets lonely because if you have to go out, you cannot leave your baby at home and go out. I'm not talking about just going to the running, I mean going on an errand, a quick errand and coming back. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about actually going out, like visiting and all of that. You start to think about all the things you have to pack for the babies, how you have to carry the babies and go all of that distance and all of that, and you just give up. You just end up giving up and sitting back at home, and that gets lonely. Imagine the irony. You have two babies that are supposed to be keeping you company, like more than enough company, but at the same time you are lonely. That is something that I'm definitely. But the thing is, whenever I look at them, when they are not crying, of course, when they're not crying are frustrating me. When I look at them, it brings smiles to my face, and it just brings a smile to my face and makes me realize just how blessed I am. And then I tell myself that this is just a phase and it will definitely pass. Or at least that's what everybody says. Something else that is actually a struggle is the fact that it is a lot of work. Now I'm talking work, mental, physical, every kind of work. Like if you have to do laundry, oh, please let me finish this video chat. My baby wants me to breastfeed her, and I really want to finish this video. If you have to do laundry, just know that you're doing laundry for two babies, not just for one. If you have to change diapers, then there are two diapers to change. There are two babies to bathe, two everything. Everything just doubles, and the work just never seems to end. And it's not something that you get used to over time. I guess you get used to it, but it doesn't get easier. Okay, that's what I mean to say. It doesn't get easier. I think you just get better at doing it. I have gotten better at doing these chores, but it definitely isn't
She
easy.
won, guys. I had to breastfeed her and put her down, so she's asleep now. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. If you're a first-time mom, whether you're a twin mom or you have just one baby and you're struggling, I just want you to know that the beginning is usually the hardest, and it will get better. It will definitely get better. You can't sleep at night, it will get better. Your sleep will improve eventually. And when it does, you'll be the one, even you'll not want to sleep anymore. So that you're not in this
If this is your
alone.
first time here and you like what you see, hey, subscribe already. Just hit the subscribe icon and then the bell beside it so you're the first to get notified each time I upload a new video. Also, guys, give this video a huge thumbs up if you liked it. It will let me know that you like this kind of content, and I'll be sure to make more of them. Leave me a comment. I'd like to hear from you. If you're a mom, if you're a dad, if you struggled, if you're struggling, what stage you are in, what stage of parenting you are in, and all of that good stuff, guys. Share this video, all of that good stuff. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.